Jeff, you're here with the last Leeds Sport today.
Yeah.
Talk us through your track record, Aldershot.
Well, it's an unwanted statistic, but you know, it seems like failed. I've watched probably four times this year. They've won every game. Seems like Aldershot. I've watched four of their games this year. This will be the fifth, and they've lost all of them. So I'm hoping, really, with a win today, we can shake that off and people have stopped trying to block my car from actually coming in the stadium because it was a bit time-consuming, you know?
We've got a bit of grief on social media yesterday.
Yeah, it's a little bit of banter, but you know, it makes up for the fact that I had to sit with three or four 18-year-old lads who are Aldershot fans on the way home from Tranmere, and to put that they were leery and noisy is an absolute understatement. Great ambassadors for the club in the way that they sang many songs, most about Woking, funnily enough, but yeah, I learned some lyrics to a few numbers. I might even join in with them today.
Enjoy the game.
Thank you.
Go! match sponsors for today's Vanarama National League match. Thank you.
Someone put a ball in.
Who is it?
Manny? Roy? Well, I don't know who it was.
I'm looking through here.
I was just lucky that someone beat the first man for the first time in a while, and
you can't give up, can you?
Just got to keep going, get your head on it, and that point may be massive next week, because now if we win next week, I believe we go third and take the place where we want to be. So it kind of gives us a little bit going into next week. It wasn't good enough, but like you say, that goal could be massive.
So pleased today that Aldershot and I buried the hoodoo, really. Is Jeff Brazier a bad omen on Aldershot Football Club? Well, you've drawn a game today. It's a spirited comeback. Whether you should have been in that position in the first place, not so sure.
Never underestimate the value of a point, I think the manager always says.
Yeah, you're right. Even at this stage of the season, with one game to go, we're in there fighting, so we're still in our hands, I believe. So go there next week, full of confidence. Massive game, but they're the games we want to be playing in. So I say, hopefully we go there.
Good crowd next week as well.
Yeah, yeah. Like, let's say last game of the season. What more could you want? The winner takes the third place. So yeah, set up perfectly, and like we're gonna have to have a good week now, which I'm sure we will. And we'll go there buzzing.
You work the ball so well, but when you stop doing that, you know, you let teams like Barrow sort of come in and bully you, because you had big lads. Up front, you've got Grant Holt, who was an absolute expert, sort of spoiling the game, slowing it down. But you should have been out of sight, really. You play with such width, and you've got all those gaps, but you didn't really have a midfield runner to sort of get in there, and you know, it just looked like it lacked in the final third, didn't it? But yeah, there's no hoodoo anymore, because there you go, there's your point. 1 point out of five games, not too bad, is it?
Yeah, proud of the boys, definitely. And yeah, we've, like I said, we're qualified now, second year in a row. But there's still a big game next weekend. You could say it's almost the start of the playoffs.
By the way, I forgot to say now, because of the fact that you play Sutton in the last game of the season, which will dictate who finishes in third place, I'll see you next week.
Song on so many different dials, cause I got more hits than a disciplined child. So when they see me, everybody barack, barack. Man, I'm like a young gun, fully black, barack. I cry teardrops over the massive attack. I only make hits like I work with a racket and back. Look on my jacket and hat, so damn berserk, so down to earth. I'm bringing gravity back, adopted by the major. I want my family back. People work hard just to get all their salary tax. Look, I'm just a writer from the ghetto like Mallory Black. Man, where the hell for the I used to be the kid that no one cared about. It's like you have to keep screaming till they hear you out. needed a change. I needed a break. For a sec I even gave up believing and praying. I even done illegal stuff and was needed astray. They say that money is the root of the evilest ways. But have you ever been so hungry it keeps you away? Mate, now my hunger will leave them amazed. Great, it feels like a long time coming. Bam, since the day I thought of that cunning plan. One day I had a dream, I tried to chase it but I wasn't going nowhere.